This massive, raucous crowd behind Belingon. He's got power. He's got dynamite in his hands. The Filipino. And he sprawls out early. Belingon looks to get on top of the wrestler. Leone wants to put Belingon on his back. This one's gone crazy early. This one's awesome already. Up again from Belingon. Oh, body shot from Belingon. Big hands from Belingon. Leone backs up. Belingon's exploded. A house on fire. The ticking time bomb's exploded.
Woo. That was a fast start. You can see Leone did the right thing. He tried to initiate the strike, but went in for the takedown. But Belingon got a great stoppage there. Was able to stop the repeated takedown attempts as this crowd lights up.
Oh, spinning back elbow there from Leone.
And Kevin actually attempted the takedown right there as they get into the pummel. Good hand fighting there from Belingon.
Good knees to the body from Kevin Belingon. He looks to take Leone down. Can he put the wrestler on his back? Yes, he can! Yes, he can!
That's a shock right there, if I've ever seen one. Good takedown.
Position for Kevin Belingon. He tries to posture up now. Leone's going to work up his back.
Confidence has got to be sky high right now as Team Lakay's very own Kevin Belingon takes down the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt and starts dropping the elbows.
Elbows from Belingon. A knee to the head. Leone's going to get out of this position. Elbows again. And he's cutting. He's cut Leone. Leone in trouble. Belingon unloading on him. This is punishment. This is power from the Filipino. Another cracking knee. Inflicting damage on Leone. A hapless Leone. And still a half guard position for Belingon.
Trying to attack that far side arm. Look for Leone trying to swim under the underhook there, but he's overhooked now. He's trying to pull him down. Looks like Kevin's gonna try to keep soft him up with those elbows. Leone's opened up.
Slicing and dicing with the elbows. Kevin Belingon, a shot to the body. I can't hear myself thinking in here. This place is crazy. This is awesome. Says to break. They are having a meltdown here in Manila. Take a moment to wipe the canvas, wipe off Belingon, wipe off Leone. Just crazy scenes. Here come the chants again. Listen to this. Soccer crowd in here for Kevin Belingon, and what a dominant opening round. The man fueled by the power of his mullet, and certainly has unleashed that in the opener. Those hands of Belingon are something else. You and granite, you and dynamite of the Filipino.
I thought it was the right hand of Kevin Belingon, but you say it's the mullet. Boom, there's the knee, follows it up right into an elbow. That's what opened him up right there. You can immediately see Leone checking his brow to make sure his scalp is still there.
Olivier Costa is looking over Leone. Belingon's ready to go. A tremendous start to this contest from Kevin Belingon. All aggression, all power, coupled with technique. What does Leone do from here? He gives a thumbs up to Belingon and says, yep, you got me, but he's not waving a white flag, Andrew Leone. He's got a lot of tricks up his sleeve, Leone. And what happens if Leone puts Belingon on his back?
Doing the right thing, getting on his horse, starts moving around. Let's see him start punching, maybe punching into a takedown. One, two, slide under.
Chad from Belingon doesn't want to overextend, doesn't want to rush in here and leave himself open for any sort of takedown or any sort of counter. Be patient, wise, Kevin Belingon at the moment.
Nice little 1-2 from Leone. Kevin's pushing forward, very patient, not rushing anything.
Overhand run from Belingon.
Rushed into a right hand right there, though.
Leone circling, wants to look for a takedown. For an opportunity to shoot in on Belingon. Double leg, single leg, body clinch, doesn't matter. Leone hands up high. Faked low. Clinches up and Belingon takedown. Puts Leone on his back for a second time.
Wow. Fueled by the power of the mullet and 20,000 Filipinos. Kevin Belingon does the impossible and puts the BJJ black belt, the wrestler, on his back and drops the ground and pound.
And here come those car batteries and hands of Kevin Belingon. Massive meat hooks on Belingon doing the damage on Leone. Leone controlling the Filipino's posture. Doesn't want him rising up and landing the heavy salvos. What aggression from Kevin Belingon. Close guard from Leone. He'll go back to his corner, the American, and receive some much needed instruction.
Like that.
What will the team from Mali say to Andrew Leone? What will Team Lakay be saying to Kevin Belingon?
Well, the first thing the team from Bali's got to do is stop that bleeding. Once that's taken care of, they need to initiate the ability to put some hands on Kevin, slow Kevin down. Leone needs to get on top. He had his moment here, but look, check out the hips of Kevin Belingon. Beautiful little overhook wizard throw there, but then he started dropping the elbows, and then here comes the knees. Elbow, and then, yep, there's one. That did some damage there, but the elbow was what opened up Leone. That's what caused that little gash. But then he started, kept softening him up and kept going to work on it. Great round for Kevin, the silencer. Belingon.
There was nothing silent about Belingon in that first round and about this sellout crowd in Manila. Packed to the rafters. They turned away so many people at the door tonight. Just couldn't fit them in. It's the hottest ticket in the martial arts world. Leone saying something. Beginning to Belingon's head a little. Touch clock. Second round set for three. Scored as an overall contest, but no doubt it's one that Belingon is clearly leading at the moment. What happens? That sense of intrigue if Leone can put Belingon on his back. Hasn't happened yet. Belingon scoring two takedowns in the opening round, or two times putting Leone on his back. Leone circling counterclockwise.
That's good. He's got to stay away from circling to that wrong side. If he keeps circling right, keeps moving to Belingon's left side, that's going to avoid that big right hand.
Belingon pivoting, center ring, doesn't want to give it up here. Again, Belingon like a ticking time bomb. Okay. Could explode at any moment. Oh, turn it back, kick drops him! Turn it back, kick drops him! Turn it back, kick drops him! Here comes Belingon! A clash of styles, the striking of Catalan, the submission wizardry of Naito. As we saw against Alex Silva when he won the title, Naito's striking certainly improved. Naito jabbing. Catalan taking his time, a low single leg attempt there, Sakuraba style from Naito.
A heavy sprawl from Catalan. This first takedown attempt is gonna tell us a lot. Watch Nobita try to take that leg. He still has his hands clasped. Yep, now watch him turn that corner. Catalan cannot let his leg get sucked in. Because that's what he was gonna do. He's gonna try to lace that leg, and now the boa constrictor goes to work. Watch him slowly start to inch up that body. Good little wizard defense there from Catalan.
This is always the big question. How does a Wushu world champion defend against a man of the grappling skills of Yoshitaka Naito?
I like that roll through he did to get that position. Now he's got Catalan back up against the fence. Catalan has to keep working. He cannot let Nobita suck him into this position. He's got to get that leg free. He's got to start pushing that head down. He's got to work his way back up that wall or the cage.
Catalan will need to find a way back to his feet where he can get off those Wushu strikes he's renowned for. The Filipino comes in on a five-match tear. And what five victories they have been. But he doesn't do it from here, Catalan. This is not comfort for Catalan. This is Naitoville. This is Naito territory. And this is what you said, Mitch. He grinds away. He breaks you down methodically, systematically, until you can't take any more, and he snaps on a sub and he chokes you out.
Good job from Catalan, though, to get back up. He's almost back up, but see what Nobita does is he uses his legs like their arms. He's always trying to grab your legs and suck them back in. That's the second time he's rolled through like that, but good job from Catalan. He's got to push the head away. He's got to sprawl out heavy. He's got to get his legs away from the legs of Nobita. Because that's what he's gonna keep doing. He's gonna keep trying to get control of one leg, lace it over with his leg, and then slowly start to put Catalan on his back.
Single leg locked on here from Naito, the self-confessed comic book geek. You know, you walk past Naito on the street, and the last thing you'd think the man is a former world champion.
Yeah, one of the most dangerous men on the planet. Looks like he's from a cartoon.
My accountant. Right hand there from Catalan, top position for the Filipino. Needs to get the strikes off, needs to damage Yoshitaka Naito. Good strikes to the top of the head there from Catalan. He's a four-time Wushu world champion.
He's got to hurt him in these positions. He's got to make Naito second guess getting this close to him. He's got to try to frame off that head, create a little bit of space, because that body lock is going to stay nice and tight. He can get that space, and he can start to keep delivering those shots.
Some good shots off the right hand between the eyes of Naito. What's Catalan doing there, Mitch? Pushing the head down.
Pushing the head down. He's trying to create that space. He's got to get that leg free, which he almost did. Now he's still got that wizard. That's keeping him controlled.
Oh, knee there from Catalan. He's cut him. Naito's bleeding. Catalan with the hammer fist strikes. Going after it now. Here comes Rene Catalan. The hammer fist strikes on Naito. He's doing the damage here in the first round.
The trophy model is doing a great job of controlling his posture with that wizard. He's consistently pushing the head down and keeping Naito away, but he's got to keep working on it.
Oh, my word. Have a look at that. Here come the heavy hooks again. Those car batteries of hands raining down the punishments on Naito. Catching on top of it, he may stop it soon. Catalan is just shellacking the former world champion. Is it going to go six in a row for Catalan? The damage, the hammer fist, like a madman raining down blows on Naito. Naito not defending. Catalan unloading. Naito taking more shots than an alcoholic. How many more can he take? He's cut wide open. Boom, again with the left hand goes Catalan. Now maybe the elbow's gonna come down.
Catalan's hurt him.
Oh, Naito's in trouble. He is damaged good. It's over. It's 6 minutes in a row. The four-time Wushu world champion has just beaten the former one strawweight world champion.
Wow, Rene Catalan.
Haru's gone 1-4 in his last five, 4-6 in his last 10. Eustaquio, 3-2 in his last five, 6-4 in his last 10. Eustaquio does possess that beautiful Wushu striking. Actually began his martial arts career in kickboxing, then moved to Wushu as a 14-year-old. Became a member of the national Wushu team of the Philippines. Haru ties him up, hoping for a really takedown. Gets it. Has the back of Eustaquio. Not where Jay Hay wants to be early on. 8 submissions and 11 wins for Tony Towery for a 73% finishing rate.
Not exactly the same way it happened back in 2016, but pretty close. Jehe's got to be going through deja vu right about now. You can see the way Taru's trying to lace up that leg with the arm. He's trying to trap the arm with the leg, but Jehe's doing a good job at defending right now. Taru's only got one hook in, but he doesn't need both hooks to finish. He can just triangle his legs and secure that position right there. The biggest danger for Jehe right now is that left arm. You can see Taru's trying to slowly work it underneath the chin. He's prying the chin up. And he's trying to work on that strangle. You can see Jehe's defending the right arm of Taru, not allowing him to lock the arms together. So it's very important that first he defends the choking hand, and then he can work off the other one.
Taru hunting for history to repeat itself. And here make it choke Jehe Eustaquio again. Eustaquio hasn't finished an opponent himself since January 2016 when he played South America in the first round. Over at Eustaquio, 2 knockouts, 2 subs. 11-7, Taru, 8 subs.
That's good.
Taking his time here, 15, Tony Taru.
Taru went under the right arm there of Jehe, so he's a little bit out of dangerous choking position. Right now, Taru is just kind of hand battling right now. So you can see Jehe's okay because he's defending the hands correctly. Taru's might transition here to mount. Jehe might go belly down. What happens here if Jehe can defend properly? But he scrambles, he gives up first position. Taru let the hook go, but he's slowly starting to work that arm underneath the chin of Jehe.
The full contingent of Team Lakay megastars in the house tonight. Eduard Folayang, Joshua Pacio, both competing later on now. Colmain and main event. Honorio, The Rock, Benario, Kevin Belingon, all of them world champions. Present all here tonight, along with coach Mark Sanjay. The amazing Team Lakay from Baghdad City. Now, Jehe, top position. Now it's Jehe's turn. This crowd goes bananas. Inside the close guard of Taru. How the tide has turned. And these now from Jehe.
Jehe did a good job defending, was able to free himself from that hook, and then once he was able to get rid of that hook, he was able to turn the position, end up on top position. Right now, you can see Taru starting to go high guard, trying to get nice and high on that guard so he can control the posture of Jehe and not allow him to posture up and start punching.
The sold-out crowd inside the massive Mall of Asia Arena is deafening when they pop for Jehe Eustaquio. You think this is definitely? Wait till you see Eduard Folayang later. Wait till Joshua Pacio comes out their main event. They go absolutely off their rockets. Eustaquio, Drake open the guard. Can he posture up and work the ground and pound? This is Eustaquio's busiest year ever. His fourth match this year, making 2019 his hottest year. Taru, 1-5 in one championship. There was a time of 3 years between 2011 and 2014 when he went to a magnificent 10-match winning streak with 7 finishes, including a Gogo Plata that got him signed to one championship. Gogo Plata, or a shoulder lock. And a Plata win for the Gogo Plata against Eustaquio tonight. It happening. And again, you never know. Drive from Taru. Turning back to Wushu style from Eustaquio. Wushu's main weapon. Known for its cutting side kicks. To the legs, to the body. A wild drop that almost took out the winner. Just on the bell there from Eustaquio.
Well, we said from the beginning, Taru needed to get this match to the ground, and he did just that. Beautiful duck under there of the big left hook coming from Jehe. Taru was able to sneak around, get the back, control the position, and spend a couple minutes in a very dominant position until this moment where Geje was able to ignite the crowd, end up inside control, work his way back into top, and then get back up onto his feet to do a little bit of his handiwork.
Once again, folks, don't forget to follow us across all your social media platforms. At One Championship on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Sparkling crowd, 100% behind Geje Eustaquio, the former flyweight world champion.
Ready, go!
Eustaquio, who holds a master's in physical education from University of the Cordilleras. The outside making from Geje. A sweeter human being you will not find than Geje Eustaquio. Very softly spoken, always with a hand and action. Man inside the ring, inside the circle. He can be a monster. You see the Wushu striking coming to play again here from Eustaquio. He's beaten the likes of Johnny Silva, Alex Silva, Adriano Moraes. It is revenge on Tony Taru tonight. Hook there from Taru. Thin with the heart and the reach. One arm, long legs on Taru. Good stiff jab from Eustaquio. Planting right hand. With a change here from Eustaquio, Mitch. A little more pepper behind that. The punches now.
Yeah, he's doing a beautiful job of slipping the jab of Taru and coming in and throwing left hands of his own. And he's starting to touch Taru a lot. There's a lot of significant strikes landed. And now he's starting to put the right hand behind that left hand. And he's starting to really add up the combinations.
Now Taru would like to put hands on Eustaquio, take him down, get on top, or maybe even take Geje's back. Tried for a tough pinch there, couldn't get the knees off though, Tony Taru. Good jab from Eustaquio, snaking it through the guard of the fin. Overhand right to left hook, nothing but air. Double jab, Eustaquio. Outside leg kick, slung it in. Hitting the top of the quadriceps of Taru. Taru edges forward. If you're going to throw the jab, got to throw the right hand for company here, Tony. Eustaquio, chin tucked, looking through his brow. Uppercut to left hook. Left hook again with a bit of a skip in there from Eustaquio. Want to see the kicks now from Eustaquio. Underneath, the leg kicks, the side kicks. There it is, must have heard me. This has been a good round for Eustaquio with the striking and another big leg kick just above the knee for that common peroneal nerve. Haru's got to start answering back. Eustaquio circling into the power side, showing no respect for the right side power of Tony Taru. 3 minutes, 5 remains, second of three.
Eustaquio's doing a beautiful job of slipping these punches. He's really got a good read on exactly what Taru's gonna be doing, and he's able to slide effortlessly out the way and then land beautiful shots like that. I like how he started attacking the legs too. He's starting to sweep out the legs and really start to take out the base of Taru. But this is what Taru wanted. Oh, beautiful little kick out there. And Eustaquio to get back up to his feet.
Luckily for Eustaquio, he may have made a sloppy mistake moments earlier. Up and go. Trying to knock the beard off. Leg kick. Turning back in. Oh, Eustaquio pulling out the full arsenal of Wushu striking. Here. Sounds like a football arena. We're all cheering on Geje Eustaquio. He dances. And he does a spinning back fist. And he's giving them a show. Taru needs to find a way to get Geje to ground again. In the first round. But Geje would like to get back in world title contention. 2020, a former world champion. 35 seconds on the clock, second round of three. Maybe a welcome return to his corner for Tauru.
First round.
Surprised I'm not seeing any takedowns. Like, he's not really shooting in for these takedowns, because right now this is what he does. He likes to back Geje up. There's a possibility. See, he's choosing the exchange. He likes the striking so much, but he's just getting outworked just by a beat. You can just see that Geje is just one step ahead of him. Geje's looking into that crystal ball, and he knows exactly what Talbot's going to throw.
Joe Honey delighting the crowd right at the end of the second round. And over the crowd, 5 more minutes remaining. Lunas sold out inside the massive Mall of Asia Arena. What a sight. What a spectacle. It's one championship.
Just a masterclass right now thrown by Geje. Look at that. Beautiful. Caught the jumping front kick, swept out the other leg. He thought about entering Taru's guard. He's like, nah, that's your game, not mine. Get back up. Let me touch you up some more. And then he starts working on the feet again. I like the way he's throwing that left hand. He's throwing it from all kinds of angles, uppercuts, hooks, and jabs. I'd like to see this round, he starts putting on the kicks behind that left hand. Throw the hand combination, go after the legs, go after the body, ultimately maybe go way up top, go head hunting up in the skyscraper and try to take out the fin.
Third and final round between Tony Tauru and Geje Eustaquio. Repeat or revenge? If you're scoring round by round, it may very well be one of these. This is scored as an overall contest. Chance go up for Geje Eustaquio again. Philippine fans love it when he delivers on the Wushu. Off a loss last time now, violent knockout to Yuya Wakamatsu on August 2nd. Eustaquio, a 34% finishing rate. Tauru, 73%. That's up new kick from Eustaquio. Fourth match of 2019, his busiest year to date. Average match time is now 16 bouts, 14 minutes and 13 seconds. Tauru's average match time is now 12 outings, 8 minutes, 25 seconds.
Now we're starting to see more kicks from Geje. He's starting to go inside, outside on the leg kicks, slowing down the movement of Tauru, get him a little bit more stationary so he can start landing some bigger weapons. I like this strategy change in the third and final.
How it goes, buddy, then goes man. He's hoping to connect to the rebound in the first match. Up again. Tries to put the chin through the top of the head. Another up again, followed by a lead hand. Jab two from Geje, follows with the left hook. Check there from Tauru, tries to pull the head down, and Geje Eustaquio, good jab from the field.
Tauru's got decent hand combinations. He's doing well. I like the shoulder roll he's trying to implement. But he's just getting touched too much. When Geje's entering into these strikes, he's not really overcommitting, so he's not giving Tauru the opportunity to duck under for the double leg. Very smart strategic game plan being executed by Eustaquio.
How nice is Eustaquio's turning back kick to the guts. Let's see if he does it again. Goes to that middle section. River about the size of it. Goes for it, he gets it. That's the little knockout. That's the one I spoke about. It's good night, Irene. Came out 2 days ago and said quite boldly, I will beat Pacio inside of 2 rounds. Pacio laughed when he heard it. He said, well, you want to do it inside of 2? I'll do it inside of 1. And they go to ground inside the opening 17 seconds.
I asked Silva if he was going to pull guard. He said, I'm thinking about it. And he just did just that. Got the overhook, slid right into guard. Now he gets to work his magic off his back. Good job by Pacio to escape that. I let him back up.
Indeed, Pacio allows the former champion back to his feet. Will we see some Wushu striking now from Pacio? Good counter right hand there from Alex Silva. Pacio with a bolo punch.
Pacio is standing his ground. He's not too concerned with the way that Alex Silva's closing that distance into boxing range. Alex Silva's getting very close. He can touch you with the hands. He might be able to drop down and snatch up a single leg.
We know the improved striking on Silva, particularly with his leg kicks. We saw that against Naito, when he beat Naito with beautiful leg kicks. Step up knee there from Pacio. Both men in orthodox stance. Thrusting jab from Pacio. Silva looks for a low single leg. Wild hands there from Little Rock Alex Silva. Pacio looks calm and collected. The young 24-year-old champion, the 37-year-old former champion, eats an uppercut off the right hand.
Look at the timing of Pacio. These are clean, crisp strikes that he's landing. Everything from the uppercut to the head kick that I'm sure is coming real soon. He is starting to figure out the distance and the speed of Alex Silva.
Silva momentarily switched to southpaw, now back to orthodox, charges in, clinches up with Pacio. They do a tango, backed up against the wall here, dropped down for a single leg to Silva.
This is what Silva has to do. He has to chain wrestle. He has to tack the single leg. If he doesn't get it, he's got to float into something else. But he is able to get this. It's not maybe the way that he wants to do it, but he is able to get this contest to the ground.
Is this advantageous for Silva or for Pacio?
Anything on the ground is advantageous for Alex Silva. He is a BJJ world champion who has very incredibly fast submission skills. You make one mistake, you leave one limb exposed, and he will try to take it back home to Singapore.
Mitch, is there a situation where you could see Pacio possibly submitting Silva?
I mean, anything is possible in this game, especially if Pacio starts launching into some of these big head kicks. If he can stumble Alex Silva and then jump on top of him, catch him and as he's discombobulated and hunt for a finish, I could see that happening. But in a straight grappling situation, probably not going to happen.
Nice jump turning back kick, aim for the liver from Joshua Pacio, the young champion of the Philippines in the red, the challenger of Brazil in the white. 150 remaining, first round set for five. World Strawweight Championship on the line. Southpaw back to orthodox for Alex Silva. On the balls of his feet, Silva. High kick nicely done, roundhouse off the lead leg, no switch up from Pacio.
How composed Joshua Pacio is, completely relaxed and calm, just waiting for his moment, picking his shots.
Not rushing, not overextending. He knows the wily veteran that is Alex Silva, and Silva knows all the tricks in the book. Silva even wrote some of the tricks in the book.
Silva competed at one championship, two. 2012, that's how long he's been in this game, man. He's got so much experience. This is his moment. He might not get another shot at the top of the mountain.
Southpaw stance again from Silva, now back to orthodox. Skip up outside leg kick from the Brazilian. Wants Pacio to go to ground. Pacio says no. Hammer fist to the foot of Silva. Not quite ready to let the former champion up. Slings the legs a little. Olivia Costa may allow him to stand up in a moment. And up they get. A very big difference in style. The strike at Pacio, the grappler Silva. Now Silva top position. Could be stuck in the guillotine here. This may be Pacio's chance to sub Alex Silva. But Silva's safe. He's seen it all before. Top position now for the Little Rock.
Yeah, Silva needs to keep that pressure. He can't allow Joshua Pacio to have any little bit of space. He's able to end this match on top. Nice little attempt at a leg block there as he dives just as the last 10 seconds. I like the strategy coming from Alex Silva, but he's got to do a little bit more work. That's three attempts he's had at a finish at the bottom. He's been on the ground three times, but Joshua Pacio's confidence got to be at an all-time high. Look at this beautiful timing. This is what Alex Silva needs to be concerned with. It's these entries into the takedowns. Pacio is starting to figure out this timing. If he takes another step back, starts launching into uppercuts, and he starts to work the timing of that knee, here's a guillotine attempt by Alex Silva. Alex Silva was more concerned with passing the legs than protecting his neck. That can just goes to show you a little bit about the ground confidence coming from Alex Silva.
We're ready to roll, second round of five. The World Strawweight title on the line. Left of screen, the champion, 24-year-old Joshua Pacio. Right of screen, the challenger, former world champion, Alex Silva. Inside the sold-out mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. A magnificent, glittering spectacle. The cauldron Everyone in the corner of Pacio as they touch gloves for round two. Very impressive opening stanza from the champion. Overhand right from Silva. High kick from Pacio. Silva locks onto a single leg. Pacio not going to ground. And now puts Silva on his back.
Look at the way Silva's trying, chasing those legs, cutting after a leg lock. Good job by Pacio to settle down, control the scramble. Now he's in guard. Let's see if Alex Silva starts to push down those legs. Alex Silva has an old school style of BJJ. He likes to pass the guard, get into side control, look for mount, and then look for one of those arm bars.
Alex Silva, a 100% submission finishing rate. Every time he has finished an opponent, he's done so via submission. Now, don't forget, Silva said he would finish Pacio inside of 2 rounds. He's got 3 minutes 55 remaining to make it come true. He's stuck in an attempted guillotine choke, but he's out of it. Inside the closed guard of Pacio. It was a very bold statement. Unlike anything we've ever heard from Silva. Usually doesn't make predictions, Alex Silva. Usually says what will be, but certainly made a statement. He would finish Pacio inside of 10 minutes.
Good job by Pacio, just to kind of control the overhooks, control the head posture of Silva, not letting Silva posture up and start dropping ground and pound, not allowing Silva to work his way past the full guard here of Joshua Pacio. Pacio still looks relaxed and comfortable. Silva's got to push down on that leg, try to work past it.
3 minutes 5 remains. Silva still inside the guard of the Filipino. It's been a mixed bag for Team Lakay on our main card tonight. The win for Danny Kingad, the loss for Eduard Folayang. And now the only remaining world champion from Team Lakay, Joshua Pacio, trying to keep the gold in Baguio. Closes the guard again.
You can see the way Silva's trying to shove his head underneath the armpit. He's possibly looking for an arm triangle choke, but he's got to get past the legs of Joshua Pacio. Nice little transition here. You can see how he sits up, controls the leg there. It's kind of a modified rubber guard, trying to control the posture of Joshua Pacio.
Feet on hips here from Silva. Now Pacio back to his feet. Silva circles off clockwise into the power side of Pacio. Got to watch the head kick. The one that spectacularly knocked out Saruta in what was declared the knockout of the year. That was in April of last year. The head kick that came in the fourth round against Saruta. And there it is, an attempt from Pacio. Top position here for Alex Silva Dragon.
Yeah, Silva's doing a good job of getting this match to where he wants, but he's not really doing anything with it once this gets to the ground. And Joshua Pacio's got good defense. They knew they were going to be in these kind of positions, so they drilled it over and over, making sure Pacio could maintain his guard and stay out of danger. And even when Silva does able, you know, to work his way past the guard or the half guard, now he's in a triangle position. Pacio chooses to let it go. Silva's trying to step over the legs into half guard. He's got to try to push that knee down a little bit, but Pacio's doing a good job of staying out of danger. Nice job by Silva to float over. Now he's looking for a possible head and arm choke if he can get to the other side. You can actually finish it from this position right here. You can still apply that pressure with your shoulder and drive in. You don't have to be fully committed to the other side. You can choke from this position. It's applied even more in full mount. Here comes the squeeze.
Alex Silva now applies the pressure to Joshua Pacio. Can he take the championship belt back to Brazil? Alex Silva. Pacio defending.
Oh, good work by Joshua Pacio to get out of that.
30 seconds remains for Silva to find a finish inside of 2 rounds as he predicted. But Pacio survives. Silva keeps the Filipino on his back. Silva, who defended the title last time in an all-Filipino affair against Rene Catalan, beat him in the second round by arm triangle choke. And looks like Pacio will get out of the second round. They'll go into the third. Not where Silver thought he would be.
I like these entries into leg locks that he's going for. He's slick. He's keeping Joshua Pacio thinking when he hits that ground by attacking those legs. Look at this arm triangle. This was deep. First he had it in full mount. Joshua Pacio is tough as nails. This is deep right here. This is a black belt level squeeze, ladies and gentlemen. This is not just your average mixed martial artist. This is a world champion black belt level squeeze he's gotten. He was able to get out of that.
A third-degree black belt squeeze.
That's huge, huge for the confidence of Joshua Pacio. Alex Silva's taking some big, deep breaths. Both these guys are looking okay, though.
Okay, Mitch, play coach. First of all, if you're in the corner of Pacio, what are you telling him to do?
I want to see Pacio time some more of these shots. Alex Silva's closing that distance. He's trying to get in for the takedown. I want to see Joshua Pacio unload with those knees and uppercuts. As for Alex Silva, he's got to keep doing what he's doing. So the more time that he spends on the mat, the more opportunities he has to catch that submission.
Third round of five for the Strawweight World Championship. In the red, the champion, 24-year-old Joshua Pacio. In the white, the former champion. Tonight, the challenger, Little Rock Alex Silva. Don't forget, folks, to follow us across all your social media platforms at One Championship on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Let us know your thoughts so far. Outside leg kick from Pacio. Pacio, the master of inventive and explosive highlight reel finishes. Alex Silva, in the third round, thought he'd beat Pacio inside of two.
I'd like to see Pacio fake that punch and then land a kick. You can see the way Silva's starting to cover up. He's fully shielding himself, and he's kind of blinded from the oncoming attacks. Pacio could land heavy body and leg kicks when he does that.
It has been a long time since we've seen Team Lakay without championship gold. If Pacio loses tonight, that will be the case.
Nice little knee as Alex Silva tried to close that distance. You do not want to allow Joshua Pacio to get comfortable in this range. Look at that jab.
Uppercut there from Pacio. These two men representing the two mega gyms in Asia. Evolve MMA, Alex Silva, Team Lakay, Joshua Pacio. Both have produced a multitude of world champions across all divisions.
Again, that's unconventional ways to get it to the ground. That's the third time that he's kind of pulled guard to get Joshua Pacio down, but it works. Now he's got that butterfly hook on that side, so he's gonna try to elevate it. Might be looking for the legs again. Good job by Pacio to work his way back up again.
Let's see if Pacio can affect some of the Wushu striking now. The escapes from Pacio tonight, the improving escapes of all the Team Lakay combatants.
Man, you would think Harry Houdini is a coach over there at Team Lakay, because these guys vanish into thin air when you try to grab hold of them.
Circling to his left here into the power side. Going to watch the round kick of Joshua Pacio. It'll come off the right leg. Goes downstairs with it. Jab from Pacio. Silva edging forward, wants to put hands on him, get a takedown, get Pacio possibly on his back.
I'd like to see more kicks coming from Silva. He has no fear of being taken down, so you might as well let go. Some fancy footwork.
Nice defense again there from Pacio. Wouldn't mind seeing some leg kicks from Silva. We know he does have them in his arsenal, those highly improved leg strikes. Two-punch combination from the Brazilian. Sprawl there from Pacio. Switches from a single to a double. Now up around the waist goes Alex Silva. 1 minute 50 remains, third round of five, Dragon.
Good job by Silva to work his way back up. You can see he went for the single, chain wrestled his way back into a body lock. He might look to pull guard again here. Pacio's takedown defense has been good, except for this pulling guard. That's the only thing that's in the amount of time he pulled guard.
At only 24 years old, so many records already set by Pacio. Most title bouts in one strawweight history. Most submissions in one strawweight history. Second most wins in one strawweight history. And second most finishes in one strawweight history.
15-3 record, a massive 86% finishing rate, 8 subs, 5 knockouts. Beat Rene Catalan by arm triangle last time to defend the title. Of course, that magnificent head kick knockout in the fourth round against Saruta. We know that Pacio can finish opponents in the deep water in the latter rounds. Close guard from the champion at the moment.
You got to think the youth advantage that he's got, the 13 years younger that Pacio is, that's only going to play to his favor as the match goes on. But now they're starting to get slippery too, so it's going to be even harder for Silva to hold on to Pacio. So that's going to play into the favor of the explosive Team Lakay athlete, Joshua Pacio.
25 seconds remaining. What has been a thrilling contest so far. Nice and cool inside the Mall of Asia Arena. We hit about 32 degrees Celsius in Manila today. It's currently 25 degrees outside. As Mitch said, some sweat starting to form on both these athletes. A jump turning back kick aims towards the liver of Alex Silva. And there's trying to loop the shin around the back of the neck. It's the main event of ONE Championship Fire and Fury from inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. Wherever you're watching, folks around the world, broadcast to over 140 countries. Hope you're enjoying all the action. Don't forget, follow us on social media at ONE Championship on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. High kick there from Silva. Southpaw stance from the Brazilian. Round kick from Joshua Pacio. Switching stances, Silva drops down, looking for a takedown, but it's Pacio in top position.
Beautiful little underhook push down right there from Joshua Pacio to maintain that top position. You know, in these fourth and fifth rounds, you have got to give a slight advantage to the conditioning of Joshua Pacio. These guys regularly run up mountains for their morning runs. Like, just the endurance that these guys are known for, they can push hard all five rounds.
They're always training at altitude, right? Mitch Baguio is up there in the hills.
Yes, it is.
What altitude is Baguio City at?
It's 11,000 feet. Could be wrong. Hit me up on Twitter, let me know if I'm wrong.
Looking for a downward elbow, Pacio from inside the guard of Alex Silva. A little bit of damage under the right eye around the orbital of Silva. That was mostly incurred in the first round from the striking of Pacio. One foot on hips here from Alex Silva. Controlling the posture of the Filipino, the world champion in the red trunks. Mitch is consulting Google at the moment to find out the elevation of Baguio City. Just to clarify, Pacio, can he get the arms free here and drop some leather, some anvils on the face of Alex Silva? Silva trying to lift him, to no avail though for the former world champion. Butterfly guard now for Alex Silva. A lot of options available. Back to a foot on hips here for Silva.
You can see that Alex Silva's having a hard time getting a hold on Joshua Pacio because of the slipperiness, that this sweat after four rounds is starting to build up. But Alex Silva's constantly looking for different attacks. He's got so much mat time in his life. He's so dangerous, especially off his back. But that sweat, you can see Joshua Pacio was able to pull out because the legs are slippery now.
Crowd loving the chance that Pacio may be able to strike now. Genuflect position back onto his feet for Pacio. And the boss, Olivia Cost, says to Alex Silva, stand up. By the way, Mitch, Baguio City, 5,000 feet above sea level.
That was completely off.
Jab two, another jab there from Pacio. Turns the knuckles in on the lead hook, does Pacio. And Silva comes forward. Knee to a right hand. High kick from Silva. That came close for the Brazilian. Body shot from Pacio. Silva edges forward, goes the outside thigh kick. Both men trade jabs. Left hand from Silva, didn't have the mustard behind it.
I gotta say that Joshua Pacio is putting a lot of the critics of Team Lakay to rest. There's been so much talk about the lack of ground game coming from Team Lakay, but he is showing a definitely elevated level of grappling. He's been able to stop all of Alex Silva's attacks on the ground. Look at it, piecing him up with that jab. Beautifully done on that straight right pad, and he follows.
Oh, high kick to a spinning back fist to a left hand. What a combination from Pacio. A beautiful combination. Now a double leg, and now a single leg from Silva. And Pacio defending. Silva wants the Filipino, the world champion, on his back.
Look at Alex Silva. He's trying to float over, but a good job by Pacio to maintain that guard. But look at that reversal. Now Joshua Pacio's on top. Alex Silva does a nice little hip escape to retain half guard.
This is a thrilling contest. This highly educated Philippines crowd enjoying the ground battle between Pacio and Silva.
You can see how Silva tries to go underneath that leg, trying to attempt deep half, looking for a submission. But Joshua Pacio, very well educated on the ground game, able to keep those heavy hips and prevent Silva from going anywhere.
Feet on hips from Silva. Trying to sub out Joshua Pacio. 20 seconds remains, fourth round of five.
Nice little elevator sweep there, beautifully done. Once he got that butterfly hook in, he was able to elevate Pacio over and reverse the position. Now he's trying to push that leg down, end up in mount.
Doesn't get the full mount on Pacio, the champion, back to his feet. Final seconds. We are going into the deepest of deep water. We're going in for the fifth and final round.
The scrambling of Joshua Pacio is intense. Look at him, timing beautifully done, leans back, little hand exchange there as Pacio floats backwards. Beautiful little knee to a right hand, but then Silva throwing a head kick of his own. Pacio backs up, and beautiful little shoulder roll from Alex Silva to avoid being decapitated by that head kick.
No one has left their seat inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena. They're on the edge of their seats for this one. The final remaining Team Lakay world champion, Joshua Pacio. One of two Filipino world champions on the one championship roster. The other being in attendance, the heavyweight world champion, Brandon Vera. And a roundhouse kick to the ribcage there from Pacio. Jumping knee, and a takedown from Silva.
Those timing on that knee is something spectacular. That was a jumping knee that caught Silva flush, walked right through it, still able to get the takedown, put it down on the ground where he wants the match most. Now he's trying to work his way past the half guard. Good job by Pacio to retain full guard.
Explosive start from Joshua Pacio. Now top position for Alex Silva. Silva is so cunning, so wily, a veteran. As Mitch said earlier, he's been here since one championship, number two. 37-year-old former champion, 24-year-old current champion. And what a thrilling show they've put on so far. Closed guard here from Joshua Pacio.
You gotta wonder at this point, how do the judges see it? It's been so close. There's been a lot of top control coming from Alex Silva, but we're not seeing ground control. He's not really advancing his position in a lot of these ground grappling exchanges. He's not passing the guard. He's not working into mount. He's been held in one position. That's inside the guard of Pacio. But has Pacio been doing enough work on the feet to push that far ahead? It's been an interesting tactical strategy by both these athletes so far to see how things have played out in the first four rounds. And now we're approaching the fifth round. It could come down to this.
You know, on his one championship debut back in 2012 at one championship number two, Alex Silva was beaten by a member of Team Lakay in Geje Eustaquio.
You can see that Alex Silva has been attempting these, trying to pull guard, trying to drop down to his back. You know, you gotta wonder, are the escapes of Joshua Pacio, the way that he is defending, gonna weigh that heavily in the judges' eyes? In my mind, probably not, because they like to see them as faceless athletes, as, you know, not paying attention to anything over their skill set and just weighing what happens right in front of them.
2 minutes 25 remains. Fifth and final round. Fake there from Silva. Thought about a sidekick. Wushu style did Pacio. Silva southpaw stance, edging forward the Brazilian. Now switches back to his preferred orthodox stance. Pacio thought about sliding with a jolt jab. Leads him with a hook instead. It is still anyone's for the taking. 120 seconds remaining. Leg kick there from Silva. Jump turning back kick. Hoping to find the liver of Alex Silva. The one that Kevin Belingon famously caught Andrew Leone with. That sent Leone across the ring summer. 15 paces. Single leg lock on here from Silva. Hunting for a takedown. Hopscotch time for Joshua Pacio. Still can't get him down, now he does. Top position, half guard for Alex Silva.
Nice single leg takedown for Silva. He's got 90 seconds to do work. He might be slightly behind in the judges' scorecards if he's taking striking superiority into factor. And that's kind of the only thing that we're really seeing from Pacio. We're seeing a lot of top control. He has been able to land a couple of takedowns, but I don't know if pulling guard really counts as a takedown as well, because you're not controlling the opponent's hips. That single leg takedown was a takedown because he pulled him down, secured the hips, and was able to stay on top. But he's not showing any ground control. He's not passing the guard of Pacio as Pacio gives a thumbs up to his fellow Catalans.
Thumbs up to the crowd from the confident young world champion, Joshua Pacio. What improvements Pacio has made over the last 18 months. Almost unrecognizable, especially with his ground game. Nice elbow there, and Pacio forced to quickly count his teeth. Looking for the ground and pound Silva. Postures up now the Brazilian. Gets elevated by Pacio momentarily. 30 seconds to go. Half guard position. They're screaming for Pacio. What has Silva got left with 20 seconds remaining? Can he get the right leg out? Can he pass guard, go to side control? No, he stays inside a half guard. Has he got a final squeeze? What's he got here, Alex Silva? We're gonna go down to the judges in Manila. Peppers away with the left hand to Silva. Now switches to the right hand to the body. Then up to the head, and there it is.
Look at Joshua Pacio slowly backing up. Joes for the jumping knee. Gives up the leg in the process, and that puts him in a position where he's able to get taken down. Another single leg takedown. But in that instance, he was able to control the hips and get on top. But Pacio plays to the crowd, gives us a thumbs up. He's not really in a submission attempt. He's just kind of playing to the crowd and telling everybody that he's okay.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, after 3-5 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of the blue corner. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of the red corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision.
In the Philippines, the reign of gold continues.
Ready, ready, go!
And the Catalan bounds out of his corner. You may see the twitches of the eye, the jerking of the neck. It's the Tourette syndrome that Amir Khan has had all his life. The pro golfer, hoping to become Singapore's first ever homegrown world champion.
When I asked him about it, he says he never takes his eyes off opponents despite it. You know, the fans in here, they may have paid for the entire seat here at the Mall of Asia Arena, but they're only gonna need the edge of that seat tonight, Michael Schmello.
The familiar Team Lakay red trunks with the Filipino flag for Eduard Folayang, the former world champion. Hard left roundhouse kick out of southpaw stance for Khan. He's got the most knockouts in one championship history. Folayang's got that Wushu style, those powerful side kicks. Amir Khan is a Muay Thai stylist.
Belingon switches stances very well. He floats between southpaw and orthodox effortlessly. He mixes in a lot of different styles. Oh, look at Folayang spinning already.
Both men coming close there. The high kick from Khan, the spinning back fist from Folayang. Outside low kick for Lyon. Needs to bring the hands up afterwards, not to get counted. Celebrated his birthday yesterday, Eduard Folayang. Will he be given the gift of reclaiming championship gold? Big outside low kick. There's the counter from Khan I spoke about. Folayang must keep his hands up when he strikes.
Jack came off very fast.
Khan can knock you out from anywhere. He doesn't need much room. Could knock you out in a phone booth. The Singaporean checks the low kick, goes to the counter down the center corridor.
Khan seems very content to stay in orthodox. He's timing his jabs nicely. He's closing the distance very fast with that right hand as well.
Khan, switch up roundhouse kick from the Singaporean. Inside leg kick misses the target. He loaded fully up on that, did Eduard Folayang.
Fully committed to these shots, Michael Schiavello. But having a little bit of distance, they blitz in, they blitz out. Oh, Khan goes after him, but look at that takedown from Eduard Folayang. He's in the guillotine.
Good attempt here from the near Khan. No avail though. They're on the floor for the first time. 2:20 remaining, first round. Now back on the feet, out of the guillotine attempt goes Folayang. Throws a knee to the upper left rib cage of Khan. Then goes down to the thigh. And once more to the thigh from Folayang. A real tussle against the wire here.
They've got 50-50 position. Each one has an underhook, each one has an overhook. Now, look for the knees. Watch Folayang's knees. He's an expert. His hips are back. He's pressing off the cage with his butt so he can create a little bit of space to deliver those knees. Now he's got Khan up against the cage.
Break off some room for Khan to work his high kicks perhaps.
Khan looks to pack down a little bit of muscles since the last time we saw him. He's looking really thick.
Folayang, little flicking back fist there as Khan was almost off balance. Front kick from the Singaporean. Folayang resets, center of the cage. 1:25 remains now in the first round. We are set for five for the lightweight championship of the world. They pinch up again, drive Folayang back against the cage. Couple of knees off the right leg there from a former world champion.
Khan likes that overhand right as Folayang's missing it. Khan's lunging forward, throwing that big right hand. Folayang's been able to evade it so far. A little bit of time spent up that cage. The reversal by Khan was in the crowd.
Chance go up Folayang here in Manila, the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena. It's one championship conquest of champions.
Nice knee landed by Khan, but you can see Folayang didn't like it. He's a little more cautious. Look at him guarding the hips with those hands.
Nice knee again to the midsection, trying to fold him in half like a piano accordion.
That was the plan of Khan. Go to the body early. Hurt him with push kicks and knees inside the clinch.
Some distance now for both men to get their strikes up. Who will land first with 20 seconds to go in the round? Front kick from Khan. Southpaw stance on the Singaporean. Looks for the inside leg, does Folayang. Oh, cutting Wushu's side kick to the lead thigh. An outside crescent kick, a little left hand over the top. Combination from Folayang. Spinning back. You do. There's the end of round one.
Wow, very close round. A lot of very, very close counters. You can see as one exchanges, the other one comes right back. The first part of that round was a lot of posturing, but look at this. Watch. Boom. Big leg kick landed by Folayang. Khan saw that counter. He's starting to counter very well with those punches. He's waiting for Folayang to kick, and he's attacking the head with the punches. Then he starts going to the body. He's watched that rear push kick from Khan going to the body, and then watch the knees inside the clinch up against the cage. Inside that clinch, you can see Folayang started to protect his body from those knees with putting his hands on Amir's hips, just so he created a little bit of separation and also judge that distance. The second round, watch for Amir Khan to increase the volume of kicks that go to the body. He might even start throwing in the roundhouse off of the switch.
Amir Khan said 100% I finish Folayang inside of three rounds. Folayang with this massive crowd behind him. Second round, the lightweight world title. Inside leg kick from the former champion. Amateur round there, caught in the forearms. Folayang inching forward. Sets himself a lot lower in his stance than Khan. Good side kick, that one aimed to the liver section.
Khan's got to do something about that push kick. He's got to start stepping off to the side. Big left hook there, smack bang from Folayang.
And Khan does a quick count of his teeth. When Edward explodes, Mitch, he can explode.
He comes out so fast. He throws that left kick. Look at that switch. He comes so
side kick to the midsection, but it's a little low.
It looked a little bit low. It could have been seen as low, but Khan seems okay. Khan's not going to disrupt his rhythm. He's trying to find a rhythm. He's trying to disrupt Edward's rhythm. And he's okay.
Folayang looks like he's got a bit of pepper about him here in the second round. Throwing the strikes, got the output, got the work rate. Time for Amir Khan to pick up the pace now. Outside leg kick, missed the target from Folayang. Goes back to center cage, drifts off to his left. Stiff jab there from Khan, that was a beauty.
Like that jab, he's got to do more of that. He can't allow Folayang to start throwing target practice.
Folayang remaining high on the balls of his feet now. Looking very spry. Khan thrust the jab out again. Maybe needs a right roundhouse kick for company after that left jab. Beautiful Wushu kick again there from Folayang. Looks for the inside thigh, goes to the body, picks him up, tries to put him down, but Khan maintains his vertical status.
I'd like to see Khan start going after the legs of Folayang. Start throwing those jabs and then just putting a little bit of a leg kick on, just so if this does go into the later rounds, four or five rounds, that, you know, the movement's not quite so explosive for Folayang, because he can do this for 25 minutes, no problem. Khan's got to slow him down. Go back to the body. He's getting away from his game plan.
The Philippines currently own four world championships at one championship. Can Edward Folayang make it five out of a possible eight? That would be an incredible national achievement. Switching stance again. Khan just gets out of the way. That wicked left hook of Folayang. It is sharp and fast. Inside leg kick from Folayang. Attention here inside the Mall of Asia Arena. You just get the feeling that at any moment something could happen. Plenty of action from Folayang. Little puppy rock hand on the inside. Overhook of that left arm from Amir Khan.
Momentum is starting to shift in Folayang's favor. Now he's got him pressed up against the cage. Khan's got him. See how he attacks him? He presses him up against the cage so Khan can't separate the hips. He's not able to deliver those knees with the same amount of force because his hips are pressed up against the cage. Watch Folayang get pressed up against the cage.
Oh, spinning back fist! Inside leg kick! Here comes Folayang! Here comes the landslide! And Amir closes him down. Oh, spinning back fist again! It is champagne from Folayang!
first round, Khan did well. Look at that stiff jab. Really open it up. And then watch. Watch how he drops his head, defends, and then he throws the elbow. Beautiful timing on the spinning back elbow. Khan chooses to go airborne, flies into the air. Folayang snatches him out of the air and slams him to the canvas. What a round for the landslide.
Scenes of utter craziness inside the sold-out Mall of Asia Arena in Manila. Third round of five. Wherever you're watching in 138 countries around the world, in particular, all of our fans here in the Philippines on ABS-CBN Sports in Action, in Singapore on Octo Sports Toggle. On the edge of your seats, no doubt, cheering on these two tremendous martial arts warriors.
See, this is what happens. Eduard Folayang is starting to get more and more comfortable on his feet. Khan has to change the direction of this match. He's got to shoot him for takedowns. He's got to get Folayang to think about something else besides just the striking, because that is Folayang's world.
Here Khan trying to wind up the roundhouse kick. He's found so much success with it in the past. Third round of five. What is Khan thinking right now? He took some heavy strikes in the second round. A lesser man would have gone down, but not Amir Khan. Folayang tries for the overhand right. Khan taking his time. Tucks the chin, looks through the brow. Folayang skips in for an inside leg kick. Adding side kick to the lead thigh there from Folayang, showing that Wushu styling. What should Khan be looking for here, Mitch?
He tried to throw that big overhand right. Folayang saw it coming and was able to get out the way. Khan's got to spin around now, press him up against the cage, try to take him down. He's only just standing there. He's gotten away from his game plan. He's not throwing the body kicks. He's not attacking the legs of Folayang. He's just now going headhunting with the punches. Khan's got to change things up a little bit. Look at this pressure of Folayang driving the head into the chin.
Khan climbs towards his corner, tries to pull the head down for the meet and greet knee. Both men reset. Under 3 minutes remaining in the third round. Khan goes high. Folayang goes low. Fakes there from Amir Khan, out of southpaw starts.
He's got to put some combinations together. Right now, he's just one punch, one kick. Folayang can see that stuff coming. You got to set him up.
Folayang, double forearms guard against the left roundhouse kick. This crowd has gone silent on the edge of their seats here inside the Mall of Asia Arena. If Folayang lands again like he did in the second, they will raise the roof. Takedown for the former champion! To the feet goes Khan, trying to lock on a choke attempt. That's out the head for Folayang. My word, Folayang is looking sharp. But there is still a long time to go. Khan has youth on his side.
Nice elbow from the clinch. He was able to connect with that right elbow.
Folayang showing that older age shall not weary him. Khan sets the left roundhouse kick here. Chose to go the rear hand instead. Switches stance now to orthodox as Amir Khan. Is he going to go the right roundhouse kick?
Let's see him attack the leg with that kick.
Stiff jab. Tried to catch Folayang coming in. Folayang fakes off the lead. Got to make sure he keeps his hands up here, Ed Wood. Throw to toe now. Khan switches back to southpaw. Now back to orthodox. Trying to confound Folayang. Trying to mix it up, keep it fresh.
Folayang rushes him back against the wire now. Throws a corking knee.
Control. Watch how Edwards controlling the left hand there of Khan. Khan, good circle out. Side, you can see that mouse starting to develop under the eye.
The right hand, the high kick, the right hand again, and the crossing elbow. Edward Folayang, more combinations than a Sudoku puzzle. What a performance from the former champion. Catches a roundhouse kick and came agonizingly close there for Khan. And it's southpaw start for the Singaporean. Spinning back fist from Folayang. Khan tried him against the wire. Final seconds of the round. Both men throwing knees on the inside. This is how the round ends.
Eduard Folayang is starting to inch ahead. He found a lot of combinations that found success. Look at this, there was that punch coming. He was able to avoid it, goes right underneath, secures the very aggressive takedown from Khan, but Khan was able to scramble, trying to control with the front headlock, but Folayang was able to get back up to his feet. Again, look at that beautiful duck under, over the top, left hand. Folayang's mixing in the weapons well. Khan has got to change something he's doing. Right now he's only boxing. He's got to get back to the body kicks. He's got to attack the legs. He's got to mix things up a little bit, at least start to circle off, create angles, and not just go forward and back. Folayang is really putting things together. He's mixing his kicks extremely well with his punches.
We go into what they call the championship round, the fourth of five for the lightweight championship of the world. Edward Folayang, Amir Khan. Youth on the side of Khan. Experience on the side of the former world's champion, Folayang. Khan looks for an early takedown. Folayang stops the attempt. Right in front of our commentary position now. Right tendril against the wire. Knee there from Folayang. Doubles up on it.
See, that's how good Folayang is in the clinch. Even when he's being pressed up against the cage, he still finds a way to create a little bit of space with his hips and throw those knees. Look at that. Three, four unanswered knees. Five knees now that have all landed to the body. Even inside the clinch, he's very dangerous with those knees because of those little subtle ways he's able to find that space and land those knees.
Muay Thai style, Amir Khan would love to look on that Muay Thai clinch. Not going to happen at the moment, though. Oh, spinning back fist, caught him on the orbital. Beautifully done there from Folayang. Turning like a tornado, fires out the left kick.
The third time he's been able to exit and throw a spinning back elbow. Every time he clinches up the cage, he lands the knees, softens up the body, and then Khan starts to drop his hands. Folayang, spinning back elbow. Third time he's done it. Good job by Khan. Now he's starting to threaten the takedowns. But the takedown defense of Folayang is so good. He gets the underhooks, presses Khan up against the cage. Now he's attacking the legs for the takedown his own.
Into the inside thigh from Folayang. Looks for the horizontal elbow.
He's controlling the hand right here. Right, there's one elbow. Let's see if he spins. He can't spin because of the underhook on the left side.
Oh, those elbows slicing up. Amir Khan. Caught under the right eye of Khan.
See, now he can spin. Now he can spin with the right side. Yep. Chooses to go right up the middle.
Uppercut elbow from Edwin Folayang. It's all coming off the right arm of the Filipino. Tries to put the chin through the top of the head. The heavy artillery from Edward Folayang. Amir's face showing the signs of those punishing Folayang elbows. What's a sinker choke here on Folayang? Folayang puts the head out. Lands another left hook.
That's the biggest difference, Michael, that I've seen in Edward Folayang so far is up against the cage. That clinch is doing damage up against the cage. This is a completely new element from Edward Folayang. This is not something he's had. The way he's damaging little tiny shots. Oh, big head kick.
That's two high kicks in a row. The game terrifyingly close. close for Amir Khan. Folayang's got to keep that right glove glued to the side of his face.
That's not his style. He doesn't really protect that head. He likes to relax. He likes to flow. See how that hand keeps drifting down?
Folayang breathing a little heavier now. Fourth round of five. Gets out of the way of that high left round. Slow down a little for Lyon. Can Amir Khan capitalize? He's got the youth, Khan. Lyon sets the right hand here. Rips off. Wushu kick to the lead leg. Circling into the power side, though, of Amir Khan. Folayang. Both men trade, it was Khan who drew the shots. Just spinning hook kick! The acrobatics from Eduard Folayang. Thought about that side kick downstairs. 1 minute remaining, fourth and five. Catch of the roundhouse kick there from Folayang. Southpaw stance here now on Amir Khan. Now switches back to orthodox. Folayang, gotta watch those turnarounds. That's what Martin Nguyen caught him on when he got knocked out last time. Spinning back fist, duck under there from Amir Khan. Looks the inside leg just Folayang.
Like, see him shoot for a takedown as Khan's spinning, but he's doing such a good job at defending the takedown so far. Khan's got to keep start kicking again. He's got to attack those legs. Folayang's movement hasn't slowed at all.
Spinning kick, inside thigh kick from Folayang. Was it huge? Final seconds of the fourth. We're going into the fifth. The deepest of deep water. Amir Khan has never been here before. Eduard Folayang has many times. How will that factor into things? Amir Khan, never been to five.
Let's watch Folayang do work up against that cage. The little subtleties that he's bringing to his game have completely changed. Watch this, he creates a little bit of space there with his hips, right? Boom, lands one knee, boom, there's another knee. Look how he opens up the arm of Khan and lands those knees. Then he forces the arm down, gets Khan fighting the arm. Boom, comes right up top with a beautiful over the top.
Here we go, the fifth and final round. Tension in the air. On the Philippines claim fifth world champion here at One Championship. Khan comes out of his corner quickly. Throws the high left round, that's his prime weapon. Shoots him for a double, sprawl out there from Folayang.
Takedown defense has gotten so much better. Khan's usually been able to take opponents down, but Folayang leveled up.
Wrist control, both men jousting for it. Spinning back elbow from Folayang, then goes down to the thigh. Crossing elbow from Folayang. Overhook on the left arm for Amir Khan. Wants to sink a choke of the Filipino. Folayang defends against it. And they break off. Let's see if Khan gets the roundhouse kick off the right leg here. Folayang is drifting into it. Overhand right from Khan. Will Khan switch back to southpaw stance? There's the high left roundhouse out of southpaw. Now back to orthodox. Shoots in. Another takedown defense from Folayang. Overhooks the right arm.
Takedowns and takedown defenses score the same. So Folayang is scoring with all these takedown defenses beautifully. It's that cage control we were talking about at the beginning. Folayang takes this match where he wants to. If he wants to keep it on the feet, that's where he does it. If he wants to keep him up against the cage, Folayang keeps him up against the cage. If he wants to keep it in the dead center, he's doing it.
Mitch Amir Khan's mouth open here. Is the younger combatant fatigued in the fifth and final round?
I believe so. Folayang has never gotten tired. Look at him, still throwing the heat with the feet.
You train at those high altitudes in Baguio City. One thing all Team Lakay has is cardio for days.
But not just training at high altitude, it's the work rate that these guys put out. It's constant. They do so much conditioning, so much training. They're such highly refined athletes in every sense of the word.
Nice elbow there from Folayang off the left arm.
Watch the elbow. See how he controls the hand? Boom, he pins down the hand and comes up with the elbow. Look at that.
Slicing and dicing with the elbows on the inside. The former world champion. 2:35 remains, fifth and final.
Those are little shots, but man, they are paying such dividends right now. He's controlling the clinch so well.
Jab two attempt there from Folayang. Khan's got to go, and he's got to go soon. It may be time to throw caution to the wind and pull out all the stops for Amir Khan. Folayang, ooh, that came close, a matter of millimeters. Jab there from Folayang, uppercut from Khan, a right hand from Folayang. Folayang gets out of the way of the jab. Orthodox stance for Khan, who has switched the entire contest. Folayang goes to the outside lead leg. Spinning heel kick! That came close to shin. I should say heel to neck. And that connects. It's good night for Khan. Uppercut from Khan, nicely done. There's a jab from the Singaporean. Is he going to get his second wind here with 1:30 remaining?
I think we're looking at his fourth wind right now, Michael. He's trying to push forward. He's trying to keep hunting. But look at Folayang going for the takedown. Good defense from Khan, though.
Khan stays vertical. We're moving towards the final minute of this world title bout. Khan glances towards his corner.
No, but again!
Tried to shave the moustache off. 1 minute now. Are we going down to the judges, or will we see a finish in the final 60 seconds? It has been a champagne performance from Eduard Folayang. But Khan is not done yet. He will not wave the white flag. He will not go quietly into the night.
A sidekick! Another one!
Folayang showing the Wushu. Dropped down for a single leg, didn't have it. Pitches upstairs. Khan tried to pull the head down. Jab two for Folayang, and there's the hook afterwards.
3 seconds left in round.
Has Khan got a Hail Mary shot in reserve here? Has he got a big time? Flying kick! Eduard Folayang in the down stages with the acrobatics. Folayang bringing it home.
Kicks and the spinning kicks. This one's for the Philippines. This one's for the nosebleeds.
Emotional scenes. Standing ovation here inside the Mall of Asia Arena. What a performance from Eduard Folayang to turn on the acrobatics in the final 30 seconds, to stuff the takedowns, attempts of Amir Khan. Victor Kui to present the championship belt. My word, extraordinary world title match. Sellout crowd inside the Mall of Asia Arena. Millions watching around the world, especially here in the Philippines on ABS-CBN Sports in Action. Is there about to be an outpouring into the streets of Baguio City? Is the party in the high altitude about to begin? Or will Singapore get its first ever homegrown world champion? Let's go to Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision.
guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.